Do you seriously need an introduction for a brilliant biryani? I don't think so. You don't need to be a pro to make a good biryani. I'll tell you how. First, we'll marinate the chicken with some ginger garlic paste, some red chili powder. For extra spicy flavor, some green chili paste, garam masala powder, turmeric powder, freshly ground coriander powder, and some cumin powder. Give this a mix. Don't forget to add salt. And mix this properly. And you need to set this aside for 15 to 20 minutes so that the chicken absorbs the marination. So I'll keep this aside. So how am I making this biryani healthy? Here I'm using brown rice instead of normal basmati rice. This is comparatively healthy. You need to soak this at least for an hour. So here I have kept water for boiling. Into this, I'll add some salt, some cardamom. This acts as an aromat. Some bay leaf, cinnamon. I have drained the excess water. This goes for boiling. You need to be very accurate while cooking the biryani rice, because if it is overcooked, you won't get that texture of biryani. And if it is undercooked, then no, it's not a biryani. So now here's the trick. You need to stir the rice using these kind of spoon. In this way, the rice won't break. So moving on to our step two of marinating the chicken. I'll put yogurt into the marinated chicken. Now after yogurt, I'll put some fried onions, which is a must in a biryani to get that sweet flavor. In case you don't know how to make this, very simple, slice the onions, deep fry them and place it on an absorbent paper. So you'll get these nice crispy onions. Now in goes some freshly chopped coriander, some mint, some ginger juliennes. That's it, give this a mix. Now after mixing this, you can taste the marination. Perfect. You need to keep a constant check on the rice. I guess this is done. Need to cook it 75%, not more than that. Drain this. Now after draining the rice, I'll add some caraway seeds while the rice is hot. It will enhance the essence. To this, I'll add saffron. Give this a light mix. I'll keep this aside. And now in goes the chicken. With the marination, do not waste anything. This is how a kacche gosht ke biryani is made. Kacche gosht ki biryani is raw mutton biryani. I have taken inspiration from that and I have replaced mutton with some chicken, and on top here comes the rice. You need to spread the rice evenly. Now on top of this, sprinkle some garam masala powder. Now on top of this comes chopped coriander and some mint leaves, ginger juliennes, fried onions, some more saffron on top, and not to forget some ghee. Without this, biryani is incomplete. Ghee is clarified butter, which is very much Indian, but this is trending all over the world because of its health benefits. Just a drizzle of water for that extra moisture. Now here goes the kewra essence. Kewra is screwpine essence and some rose water. And this goes on flame. I'll cook this on low flame. Traditionally, this is cooked on dum. Dum is nothing but you seal all the edges. You see to it that the air doesn't escape from the pot. Dum cooking ensures that there is even cooking from inside and the flavors are fully intact. So this goes on low flame for 15 to 20 minutes or till the chicken is perfectly cooked. Sign of a good biryani is its aroma, and I think I have achieved it. Wow, let's plate it. Let's keep it simple. Now comes the garnish part. Some fried onion, some ginger juliennes. Food should not only taste good, but also look good. So it's very important to garnish it. So here you go. a beautiful biryani presented in a simple way. Because sometimes happiness is in simplicity.
For more such delicious recipes, stay tuned to Sanjeev Kapoor Khazana.